Stuart, you've been a contestant on MasterChef. You run your own bakery and you've released your own cookbook, Stacey Bakes. What type of cakes do you specialise in, Stacey?
Hopefully nice ones, mate.
Really nice ones. Nice ones. Is that your real hair?
Yes. Sorry, I didn't touch.
Don't touch.
You can touch if you want.
Well, it is.
I think it's brilliant. You would think there's something underneath it, but it's your own hair teased back and wrapped around.
That's where she keeps her cupcakes.
Yeah.
She's well, you're hungry. She's got a cupcake. How long is your hair when it's down?
Down there.
Is it?
Yeah. Wow. Keeps us warm at night.
Okay, so do you bake, John?
I actually do. I love baking.
Do you?
Yeah.
What sort of things do you bake?
Well, I love baking cakes. One of my favorite is carrot cake. And I love doing that with a good cream cheese icing also,
which is
what this is. I'm a bit of a baker.
We had loads of people tweet us earlier about that. What's that cake we had on the
Simnel?
Simnel cake. Yeah. Do you know the history of the Simnel cake? They're saying it's for Easter, not for Mother's Day.
It's not, it's Mother's Day. It's traditionally the middle Sunday of Lent. That's what it was made for. And the middle Sunday of Lent is now Mother's Day. So you were right, it is a Mother's Day cake.
Okay, cool. Good stuff. So what we're going to do, we're going to make red velvet cake. How does it become red velvet?
Yours has kindly been levelled off, but I'm going to have to level mine. But I'll level as I talk. And you need to level a cake off. One, because you need it to be flat before you decorate it. And two, because we need the crumbs for the top.
Right.
So red velvet cake, butter, sugar, flour, cocoa, some eggs, some red food colouring at the front. And it's really important that you get the correct red, otherwise your cake will go brown. You got buttermilk, which makes it very rich. And we got a little bit of vanilla, and then we got bicarb and a little bit of cider vinegar. It's a classic red velvet recipe. And then the icing is cream cheese, icing sugar, and more butter.
What's the difference between red velvet and chocolate? Because they taste of chocolatey, don't they?
One's red and one's brown.
Okay, good.
It's just the colour.
Is that what it
is? It's a Southern American. It's like buttermilk, and it's very, very rich. I would put milk in a chocolate cake, but the Americans love buttermilk, so they fire it and everything. But apart from the colour, not much, mate.
It's become very fashionable, hasn't it, red velvet? It wasn't big over here, but...
No, I mean, in the States, they have been selling red velvet for a long time. In any deli or any supermarket you go into, you can always buy red velvet cupcakes or red velvet cake, and they're the best thing just to kind of buy one, go off in a corner, and just eat it.
I went to that... When I went to New York, I went to that... What's the famous Magnolia?
Magnolia, yeah.
The queue all the way down the street for a cupcake.
Yep. It's brilliant.
Did you get one?
I joined the queue.
Well, see, marketing works, doesn't it? Are we meant to be doing something
right
here?
Yeah, what are
we doing? Well, I'm just going to get myself away, and you can go as well. And yeah, just copy me.
Right, you've got four parts. Layer.
You've got four layers. And we're just going to pop a little bit of the buttercream on. You don't want to fire loads on because you're going to be putting quite a bit on the outside. You just want to give it a gentle smoosh.
A gentle smoosh. I like that.
Yeah?
Smoosh. What on earth does smoosh mean?
You're smooshing right now.
It's Magnum for spread. These little things whizzle around. Yeah, the rotate, that's the one I'm looking for.
Brilliant.
So you're meant to use this to swivel.
You are.
Look at that.
And then you just keep layering them up.
Is that enough, Chef, or a bit more?
I'll put a tiny bit more on. There we go, lovely. Yep, so we're towering it up nice and high. And then we're going to do something called a crumb coat. And a crumb coat is what you put on the outside of a cake to stop all of the crumbs going on your icing.
Okay.
We'll talk through it and we'll do it. See how when we're smooshing, we're getting loads of like red crumbs in the icing?
Yes.
So we do a crumb coat on the outside and that stops the finished cake having red crumbs all over it. It's a presentation thing. Right. There we go.
What's your favourite cake, John?
Tell you what you got there.
I love chocolate fudge cake with chocolate fudge sauce. Yep.
Sounds quite calorific.
You know what? If you're going to eat cake, it's going to be calorific. And the most important thing with any, I think, with any food, feed your face with what you like, but do a little bit of exercise.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's me.
A little bit of exercise.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, I've kind of cracked mine
a little bit.
Just lick your fingers. Lick your fingers.
Yeah, but then the viewers go, you licked your fingers.
What does
and
it matter?
To a cake.
What does it matter? You're going to eat the cake. Just lick your fingers.
I'm putting mine on eBay.
Are you? Don't lick your fingers.
Right. So what are we doing?
So
just around the edge.
So using a palette knife, right? You just pretend you're doing the grouting in your bathroom. Not that you do. I bet you've got something to do your grouting. But anyway.
Are you kidding? I'm Scottish. I do my own grout.
Do you?
Yeah. Look at that, man. You're putting me to shame. Right. So yeah, all the way around. This is called a crumb cut. We want a really thin scrape of buttercream.
A really thin.
Very, very thin scrape, and that'll seal all of the crumbs in, and that'll stop our finished cake having red bits all over it. So, yeah, we're just doing a crumb coat all over. And probably... I'm going to have to nick some of your buttercream in a minute to finish this, I think.
Really?
So,
have
they didn't make
enough buttercream.
We didn't get enough buttercream.
I like a really thick buttercream.
So do I. Right. I like the kind of buttercream that when you bite into the cake, that it goes right under your nose and then your upper lip and you've got it all left. Face full of it. Absolutely.
Right. So, that's our crumb coat done. You can leave your crumb coat for anything up to a day. So, like I say, a nice thin scrape. Now we're going to start. Look at that, that's class up.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Can I get a job with you?
Aye.
What about mine?
Oh,
it's
yeah.
It's too slow. we got to bang these out. We've got demand. We've got a queue all the way
all
down
right,
the street.
All right.
They're queuing.
Actually, you're not kidding. People will be tweeting on... their Twitter's gone mad at the moment. Yeah, it's gone mad with all the Mother's Day messages. While we're here, I'm going to read out... Can I read out one?
Yes, is
that all right?
Oh, please do.
Happy Mother's Day to Mum Karen Ward, who once protected me from a rampaging tortoise.
Steal your buttercream.
Go on, you can steal some. Yeah. And then happy Mother's Day to my wonderful mum, who has saved my life twice. That's from Alistair Pasici. Pasiti, I think that is.
Yeah.
So, loads. That's my good. Twitter account's getting inundated with them.
Is that?
Yep. Oh, is my mother tweeted?
Is your mother tweeted?
Yeah.
No.
I haven't seen her for a few weeks, so...
Well,
why not?
Because I'm working, I'm always travelling. I'm going on today. I get 2 hours back in Sunderland before I go back to work tonight, so... Going to do her some tea, walk me dog.
You've got to make time for your mum.
You
need to fill that into your calendar.
I'm stealing some of your buttercream. Because mine, yeah. Stacey right. stole mine. Because
so
her cake's got to look the best.
Yeah, it does, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Otherwise, I'd be out of a job. Right.
Yeah.
So... Once you put the creams on, you don't have to worry about it looking pretty because it... Oh, look at that, man. Great, swivelling. Right.
OK.
We're just going to do some
side
swipes.
It's not bad. We just need more buttercream.
I've got loads on mine.
I'm just going to scrape
now,
the bowl.
Are we going to decorate this?
We are. We're going to do some sugar flowers. Just finish doing my little side swipes. Then we're going to use... So the top that we cut off, that we levelled off, we put in a food processor or we sprinkle it up with our hands and that goes on top. And that gives the person eating the cake an indication of what's going to be inside. Because if you look at this, it doesn't look red.
Yeah.
There we go. That's a topper. Right, we're going to do some sugar flowers while you're carrying on. You've even done the side swipes, Tim. Oh.
I know. I was following you. I'm a good learner. I'm a quick learner.
You are, aren't you? Right.
Yeah.
So, flower cutters, you can get these online. You can get these in cake decorating stores. They're a couple of quid and you can reuse them. We've just got some fondant ice in here, which has been rolled out.
Yeah.
So, stab it in like that. Give it a little shake. Press. Lift. So we've got a lovely little flower there. And then these little pearl balls, you can get these in any supermarket, we'll pop one of those in the middle.
Okay.
And then make some pink ones. So stab, shake, plunge, lift.
Okay, well whilst we're doing that, what are we gonna do with these? Just quickly show us what we do. Oh, we put these in
the middle? Yeah, you put them in the middle.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
Right, well that's fantastic. You're doing well. I'm doing well. Thank you very much for showing us that, Stacey. After break, it's Drinky Booze time with Rebecca and we're chatting more to Laura Mueller. See you in a bit.